हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे 8 ऑफ माई लीड को चैलेंज एंड टुडेज़ क्वेश्चन इज सुपर पैलिंड्रम्स। सो विदाउट मच अडू लेट्स लुक एट द प्रेजेंटेशन दैट आई हैव क्रिएटेड फॉर दिस एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द सोल्यूशन। लेट मी जस्ट टेक अ पेन है सुपर पैलिंड्रम्स एंड जस्ट बिफोर द स्टार्ट लेट मी जस्ट रीआइट्रेट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ पैलिंड्रम। अ पैलिंड्रम इज अ नंबर और अ स्ट्रिंग दैट रीड्स द सेम फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट एंड फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट बोथ द वेज। What is a super palindrome? A super palindrome is itself is a palindromic number which is also a square of a palindrome. So there are two caveats here. One, that it should be a palindrome number itself, and other, that it should be a square of a palindromic number. What are the examples of such super palindrome? 4 is the example because 4 is in itself is a palindromic number, and 2, which is the square of 2 is 4, is also palindromic in nature. Similarly, 9, because 9 is palindromic, 3 is also palindromic, which is the square root of 9, and both the conditions are satisfied. Similarly, 121 is super palindromic in nature, because it is itself a palindrome, and the square root of this number, which is 11, is also a palindrome. Let's take another example. 484, it's a palindromic number, and the square root of this number is itself a palindromic number, which is 22. So in this question, we are given a range of left and right, both inclusive, and we need to count the number of super palindromic numbers in this given range. So let's try and understand the algorithm that I have created for this. What we are going to do, we'll create the list of all the palindromic numbers and then we will iterate over the list, check if the square of the current palindromic number lies within the left and right range. If it does, we'll check whether the square of that current palindromic number is also present in the list. If it is present, we'll increment our count variable. If it is not, we'll simply ignore that. So we have fulfilled both the constraints, that the square of the current palindrome lies within the range and is also a palindromic number because we are checking it whether it is part of the list or not, and the list is of palindromes. So the question reduces to creating the list of palindromes properly. And how we are going to do that? So let's talk about the base case. The numbers from 1 up till 9 are part of the palindromic list, and hence we'll add them upfront in the list. And for the next numbers, we'll start an iteration from I equals to 1 up till I equals to 10,000. I'll explain in the coding section why I am using 10,000 here. And we will generate palindromic numbers. So what is the first palindromic number that you can generate out of I? I plus reverse of I. Because when a palindromic number is read in left to right direction, or right to left direction, it reads the same. Therefore, it created a palindromic number using I plus reverse of I. Let's take one example. Let's assume the value of I is 1, 2, 3, and 4. How can we generate a palindromic number using this? We'll reverse the number and we get 4, 3, 2, 1. And we'll add these two numbers up. So this is one palindromic number that you can generate using I. Also, you can append any digit in between of these two numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4 plus x. X can be any digit starting from 0 up till 9. And the reverse number 4, 3, 2, 1. This also belongs to a palindromic sequence, and therefore we'll generate numbers in this way. One, I plus reverse of I. Second, I plus any single digit plus reverse of I. So any numbers would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 4, 3, 2, 1, and any number can come in between here. So without much ado, let's look at the coding part. And the first thing that I'm going to do is to create a list of long that will store the palindromic numbers, and I'll assign it a new array list. Let's find out the left number in long format, long dot parse long left. Similarly, let's shoot for the right part. You extracted the right number, and let's define a variable count that will store the count of such numbers. The first base case that we are going to do is to add all the numbers starting from 1, long I equals to 1, I is less than 10, I plus plus, into our palindromic list dot add I, and then we will create new numbers starting from long I equals to 1, I is less than 1000, I plus plus, and let's define it left part equals to long dot to string I, and let's find out the right part equals to new string builder, and I'll pass in left part here dot reverse dot to string. Now I have the right left part and the right part, which is the reverse of the left part. I'll create a new palindromic number which is equal to left plus right. Also, I'll create 10 more palindromic numbers starting from I equals to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus. I'll use left part plus this digit plus the right part. So let's call it digit instead of I. And palindromic number dot add left part plus digit plus right part, and we are done with this. We have created all the list of palindromic numbers, and let's iterate over them and find out an answer. For long number over palindromic numbers, let's find out the square of that number. Square number equals number into number, and let's check if the square of this number happens to be palindromic in nature. Is palindromic this square of a number, and we'll convert it into two string for easier computation. If this happens to be a palindromic number, we will add or increment the count plus plus, and in the end we'll simply return the count. Also, we need the other check that the square of this number should lie within the range of left and the right number, so we'll put it there. Left number is less than equal to square of this number, and right number is greater than equal to square of this number, and the number itself happens to be, the square of this number happens to be palindromic in nature. So the only caveat now left is writing the helper method is palindromic. So we'll return a boolean from it, and the method name is face palindromic, and it accepts a string str, and let's write the standard way of finding out whether a string is palindromic in nature or not. Start equals to 0, integer end equals to str.length, while start is less than end, if str.char at I at start is not equal to str of char at end, if it's an inequality case, will return false. Otherwise, it's an equality case. We'll increment start and decrement end. And once we're out of the loop, we'll return true. Assuming that there was no invalid case or mismatching case, will return true. So let's try this up. I missed some typos in the code and it took some time for me to figure that out. For example, long.parseLong, I missed this. And here also I missed long.toString. So apologies for that. Now let's try this up. Accepted. I want to highlight one last thing here, that why are we moving from I equals to 1 up till I equals to 10,000 and why not beyond it? Because the integer range is 1 till 10 raised to power 18. That is also mentioned in the question. And what we are doing, we have kept this number up till 10 raised to power 4. So the left part is up to 10 raised to power 4. The right part therefore again becomes up to 10 raised to power 4. And the palindromic number that we generated by this logic becomes up till 10 raised to power 8. And the palindromic numbers that we generated using this logic, since we added an extra digit in between, becomes up till 10 raised to power 9. And in the later part of the question, we are calculating the square of such numbers. Therefore, the range becomes up till 10 raised to power 18. This is the reason why I have kept this upper limit up till 10 raised to power 4 and have not gone beyond this range. I hope this logic is again clear to you. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please don't forget to share and comment in the section below. Also, subscribe to the channel.